to the government and consumers in the market of the Republic of Serbia. I am delighted to introduce to you the organic, fresh and rich in nutrients agricultural products from Uganda. I'm also happy to introduce to you the ancient culture, cultural products, and the people of Uganda. Our country lies astride the equator and holds four different climatic zones, which are the temperate or alpine climate on high altitudes in the west and east, the savanna in the central and western low grasslands that carries all flora and fauna, the equatorial zones in the ancient rainforests, all at 27 degrees Celsius all the year round. We produce almost any agricultural commodity you can name on earth, from fruits and vegetables, meats, dairy products, nuts and grains, and essential vegetable oils. Our products are grown on smallholder farms with very much care about the preparation, because that is what we eat. And it is also part of the heritage of the families. It is part of the heritage of the families. They don't do it just for business. They do it because that's their heritage, which has now become commercially relevant. The private sector, that is the people of business now, is slowly introducing large commercial farming to feed the region and the world, because we are only 45 million people, but with the ability to feed 200 million people and more, given the fertile lands and the increasing technical know-how of our young people. We are also in the large emerging market of East Africa and the greater African common market, which is an area of 1.4 billion people now. In 10 years, our African market will be one of the largest in the world, with young people consuming more. I thank His Excellency President Alexandro Vucic for sending me his Minister of Trade, the Honorable Tomislav Momirovic, who delivered the invitation to me to visit the Patriotic Republic of Serbia. I'll be coming with a delegation of 60 companies and business people who are bringing you food and other products. We'd like them to partner with your companies to invest more in the agriculture sector in Uganda. I am happy that you have already expressed interest in our pineapples, coffees, grains, flowers, dairy products, and banana products. We commit to offer you all incentives on land, taxes, and access to the larger market of Africa. We'll continue to use the lasting relationships we have had with you and the former Yugoslavia Republic since 1963, when we opened bilateral relations, and through the years, the work we have supported each other on at the Non-Aligned Movement and the UN. This will strengthen the cause of both our peoples, our institutions, and humanity. I visited Yugoslavia, it must have been 1988, where I was received by Lazaro, and then I visited Slovenia. It was called Lazaro, the president at that time. I would like that Uganda Airlines begins a partnership with Air Serbia on landing in each other's countries, so that we can fast track business, tourism, and person-to-person exchanges. I encourage you to utilize the trade hub, which we have named Uganda Connect, to make more orders for our products and to come and see our country. This trade hub is located at the Belgrade waterfront. Please visit it regularly to have a taste of our foods and culture. I thank the trade representative for Uganda, Mr. Bratislav, who has worked so hard to open a new bridge for trade and investments between Uganda's and Serbia's private sectors, and helped ensure Ugandan products come to your retail outlets. Welcome investments from Serbia to Uganda. And in the future, I hope the Ugandans will also invest in Serbia. I wish you all good health and a lasting bond of friendship and solidarity. Thank you.